Now let's talk about a model for a TEM transmission line. So if we want to model a TEM line, we use a very specific and interesting model. It's called an RLGC model. What we do is we consider the transmission line itself. Let's take this coax, for instance. In this case, we're going to consider the resistance along the metal. There's actually resistance of the current going down the positive line and back along the negative line. We're also going to consider the possible loss because of an imperfect conductor, that is G. We're going to consider the inductance between the inner and outer coax, so there's kind of like some inductance here, and we're going to consider the capacitance between those two. And we end up with a model that looks something like this. We have some resistance, R. We have some inductance, L. We have some conductance, G. And we have some capacitance, C. So this is a model of our transmission line. The transmission line is really big. So here are lots of sections of this transmission line. Each of those sections we're going to say has a length of delta Z. So our model is going to be right here, a little length of delta Z. Then the next piece that's next to it is going to have an R, L, G, and C, and then another R, L, G, and C, and so on. And this is how we build up our transmission line model. Let's talk about what each one of these pieces represents.